Yo, what's up? Let's talk about Lucid Air. For you guys who don't know, Lucid, they announced the Lucid Air 2 days ago. There's a live stream, so you can watch it. I will link it to the description below. You can watch it, but it's kind of long. And then in this video, I will try to point out the highlights. So the first thing I noticed was the frunk. The frunk is just huge. So they claim it's the biggest frunk of every EV that out there. I was like, wow, okay, I believe that. It might also be bigger than the Model S Classic. So that's nice, you can put lots of luggage in there. But also the trunk is quite big, they claim. Now, the trunk has this sedan opening, so it's somewhat limited what you can put in there. No large furniture, but bicycles, yeah, maybe. And also they have a big space under the trunk, just like many, like just like Tesla also tends to have. So that's also nice. And also the side, I notice also that on the each side you also have nice big room for putting luggage or whatever in there. One thing I don't like is the center display. In my opinion, the center display is way too low. Like a Model 3 or the Skoda Enyaq and many other cars coming out nowadays, they put the center display or the media control unit higher up, and I believe that's safer and easier to use. So a little bummer there. They're probably not going to change it anyway. And also the whole retracting display is cool. You can put luggage or whatever in there or some items. But the thing is that I used lots of cars with center display, and you want to have it always on. You don't want to just hide it. You know? So it's a cool thing, but kind of cumbersome to use. And then let's talk about tech now. So Lucid, they make the battery and drivetrain and power electronics and transmission and the software. They do all of that in-house. I believe that is a good thing because you have better control of how those components speak together. And then also means that you can optimize everything. So when I watched the live stream, I was so blown away by how well they have managed to develop things. So okay, and then as for the range, Lucid, they claim 832 kilometers or 517 miles of range. I find that a little bit optimistic because if the battery is 113 kilowatt hour and let's say we have 105 kilowatt hour net capacity, that means 126 watt hour per kilometer. That's even lower than the Model 3. So I don't think it's that low. I mean, the car is probably efficient, but if we assume 140 watt hour per kilometer, then we should at least get 750 kilometers of range. And I think that's more plausible. But still, you know, that is still 100 kilometers more than a Tesla long range. So very impressive figures here. But okay, the next one here, I have to show you guys. I had to pause this when I watched the live stream. I was like, what the heck? They almost just skipped through this one. It's just, you guys just have to let it sink in. The German EV brand, that is a Taycan rear motor, drivetrain. It's the inverter, gearbox, and motor in one unit. And it's, I guess because it has a two-speed gearbox, then it makes it heavy. And then the other one, the next one there is a small drivetrain for Model S or 3 or X or whatever. And then the large one, that one is for the performance, the 429 horsepower. Yeah, like for example, the one in Optimus Prime, Model X performance. But they are kind of heavy and not too much power. So if this is true, what Lucid claimed, then it's just mind-blowing that they can get 670 horsepower from 73 kilos. So I was like, wow. And also, you see how compact it is. They made it super compact. And I believe also that the gearbox is in there also. So that is amazing. They should start selling this drivetrain to other car manufacturer. And the next slide here is a little bit interesting. They look at the power to weight ratio, which looks really fancy when you see it Lucid. It looks like, okay, well, Lucid has 3 times more weight to power to weight ratio. Well, it's okay, partly true, but You have to look at the whole car, though. But still, this means that the whole car should be around 100 kilos less. So it means that, okay, you might get 5% less weight, but that is still good because less weight doesn't mean too much for consumption, but it means more for performance, you know, like, yeah, cornering and stuff. And also, well, it also actually means that you have 100 kilos more allowed weight inside the car. But also, because the drivetrain is so compact, then it allows them to also put a triple motor in. Well, the dream version, the one with over 1,000 horsepower, should have, I mean, that one will have the triple motor. And that means that it should also have torque vectoring in the rear motor, I mean, the rear axle. So that is pretty impressive stuff. But of course, the Model S Plaid mode will also have that same configuration. So Tesla, I guess after Battery Day, they're going to bring out the big gun. Yeah. And also, okay, next one, headlights. Headlights looks really promising. Headlight is somewhat underrated, especially in the Nordic countries where you have long winters and dark winters. And they have some fancy stuff. I don't understand what all of that is, but what I see, it looks nice and it should be good. And then the battery pack. Lucid, they use those small cylindrical cells on what they call it. Yeah, just like Tesla. And they manage to pack it better because Tesla, if you have those cells, right, they put cooling between them and that takes up a little bit of space. But Lucid, they manage to put all those cells, they just pack them together and then they only, okay, let me at least say like this, they only cool down the top and the bottom and they found it to be sufficient and actually quite good, they claim. So that's probably how they managed to fit in 113 kilowatt hour, just to pack it better. And the next cool thing was the Wunderbox. I think most people, they don't care about it, but I was totally blown away by the Wunderbox. So the Wunderbox has this onboard 19.2 kilowatt charger. Very nice. I talk about this all the time, that EVs should have 22 kilowatt onboard charger. I don't know if that one is 19.2 after charging loss or whatever, but it's still really, really useful to have that kind of charging speed on AC. And then they also put in, well, correct me if I'm wrong, but that box, that Wunderbox, does the step up from 400 volt to 900 volts. So if you're charging on, let's say, a Delta charger with only 400 volt, it will do the conversion. And they never mention how fast it can do it. Maybe there's a limit on 150 kilowatt or whatever, but that small box did it. Yeah, and then also it's bi-directional. The charge is bi-directional, just like a Tesla Model 3 and Y, I guess. So it means that you can also feed your home with power from your car. And also the cool thing is that you can also charge another car because it's bi-directional. But in order to do that, you need a cable. You know, it has a male and female end, so you need some kind of gay cable or something so it'll fit, but it should mean that a Lucid Air should be able to feed any other car with power. It doesn't have to be between the cars, because those other cars, they will just see the Lucid as a charging station or whatever. That's how I think it should work, but that's pretty cool. That's some features I talk about with Tesla that would be nice to at least feed other Teslas with the juice when they are running out or whatever. And then Lucid comes out with it, just like the Wunderbox with the 19.2 kilowatt onboard charger. Yeah, okay, let's talk about fast charging. So they say that it can take 300 kilowatt peak power. And then I did the math here. Lucid Air battery, it's 21% bigger than the Taycan's 93.4 kilowatt hour battery. And if you take 21% and then multiply by 260 kilowatt, which I have measured the Taycan to peak at, it means that Lucid Air could charge at 315 to match the same C rating. So you see that 300 kilowatt is actually not that fast. Well, I mean, it's fairly fast, but because the battery is big, then it can take that kind of power. But of course, we don't know how flat the curve is and all that. Most likely, it's just a peak rating in the low end, and then it kind of flattens out, but it's still decent, very, very fast. And it means that because this car is efficient, then it should be by far the fastest charging EV. It would beat Model 3, of course. Well, actually, will it? Yeah, I think it will, because the big battery is bigger, so it will maintain that nice charging speed for longer. So yeah, and then Lucid also said that they are open to sell hardware to other car manufacturers. I was like, yes, because what they should do is sell that Wunderbox and sell that electric motor. Well, I was about to say the motor, but it's just one unit with inverter, motor, and gearbox. Sell that to other car manufacturers. Oh man. As for the pricing, I should also mention that these are expensive cars, but they are also good high performance car, and they will, from what I've seen, they should have also nice interior and all that. But yeah, they had to start somewhere, and they started in the somewhat expensive range. But of course, there are people who are rich, people who can afford Taycan or a Model S X Performance. They can also afford a Lucid Air. So I think they will sell. I mean, I see lots of common people like, haha, Lucid Air is too expensive. Well, it's too expensive for you, buddy, but there will be lots of people who want to buy them. As for me, I cannot afford Lucid Air. It's too expensive for me. Hopefully I can try one, but yeah. And then of course, I think they also have a similar plan as Tesla, is that they will first make a somewhat expensive EV, and then they will make a high volume, more affordable EV. And to summarize this, you know, after I saw that presentation, I was just totally blown away, because I started thinking, EVs coming out today, nowadays, or soon, they are really not that special. Like, to be honest, the ID3, what revolutionary things did they do with the ID3? They made an MEB platform. What about the Skoda Enyaq? What is so special with it? The grill? No, they still use just regular motor. Battery is down there somewhere. Nothing special, really. Onboard charger is too slow, in my opinion. You know, but the Lucid, they have the Wunderbox. They have the big, nice pack of the battery. They use the smart cooling system, which I probably don't know too much about yet. To me, it sounds like Lucid Air or Lucid. They are really groundbreaking. They did basically what Tesla did many years ago. They innovate. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. They are innovating. Unlike many other car brands, they just make an EV because maybe people are pushing them into it or whatever. And to me, when I see those other EVs coming out today, it's like, okay, it's nice, because then you can buy your Skoda, then you can buy your Nissan EV, your favorite brand. But Lucid is just innovating. Yeah, they are really pushing boundaries. I like that shit, because it means that we make EVs even better than today. And I think this is also a nice clap to Tesla, that, and also not only Tesla, but also Porsche, because think about this. Porsche have been working on this electro auto for a long time. Yeah, it's gonna kick ass. And then Lucid comes out and like blows it away, at least in the straight line. Yeah. And also Tesla, they've been making EVs for a long time. So this is nice that Lucid comes out there and then claps all the other car manufacturers. Yeah, so they have to innovate and work harder to make even better EVs. So, yeah. I think that's gonna be it for now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, thank you for watching, and talk to you later.